Hello. Now the position location in space from the three different transmitter. We will see here that A, B, C, and the position X we are having. That is the position X here. These are nothing but the location of a receiver from the three different transmitters. This one is about a circle of intersections defined by the A, B, B, C, C, D here, and on a given particular plane we can able to find out the location from the different transmitters. Now we go ahead. This is about the position of location in a plane here, not a space. So we can consider, so to identify the position of location on in a space, if we consider the sphere there, so we can find out the space there. So now in this particular case here, we have considered the position location on a plane with a three transmitter, and here the position location on a space in a space here we have used. Now in a navigation system, the position of a satellite is defined in terms of earth-centric, earth-fixed coordinate system. So we have seen earlier that a three transmitters and the receiver was fixed, and the transmitter on the satellite, we can just measure the position of the receiver at any place on or above the earth there. Now this position of a satellite can be used a earth-centric, earth-center, earth-fixed coordinate system. We can have earth-centric, earth-fixed coordinate system. So in this case here, we say that earlier there are the three transmitter, that three satellite, and we are having a position there for the given satellite. Now in this case, the position of a three satellite A, B, and C, it is described by the coordinates x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2, and x3, y3, z3. And we say that a location here where we are receiving the information from this three transmitter, or we can say that three satellite here, so that location is XR, YR, and ZR. Means we are receiving the signal from the three different transmitter, that is three different satellite there. Now in the ACEF coordinate system, if you see that it describes with the orthogonal coordinates, that is X, Y, and Z, and it has having the origin at the center of the earth. So this is about the ACEF coordinate system. It is having the center of the earth, okay, X, Y, Z here, and the position of that center of the earth we will use to find out the range and all. Now then that Z axis, if you see that it is directed from the center of the earth towards the north pole here, from the center of the earth to the north pole. And the X and Y axis, these are about the X and Y axis, are on the equatorial plane. But if you see here, the X axis passes through the prime meridian. That is about, we are having the x-axis passes through the prime meridian, that is a zero latitude, and the y-axis passes through the 90 degree east latitude. That is about a 90 degree east latitude, and the ECF coordinate system rotates along with the earth there. Now consider that here a three positions or here, that is position of a three satellites, that is described by the ABC and their coordinate system x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2, and x3, y3, z3. And if we consider that a receiver receives and their coordinates of XR, YR, and Z are there. Now that ACEF coordinate system is used to describe the position on the earth. Now from this we can calculate the range equation for this satellite from the receiver, that is R1, R2, R3. Already we measured earlier the same, that is from the satellite to the receiver there. We can have a R1, R2, R3, this position, then XR, subscript R is for the receiver, subscript 1, 2, 3 for the respective satellite transmitters. So we'll get that a ranges of a R1, R2, R3 here using the Earth-centric, Earth-fixed coordinate system. Then we can calculate that a range that define what will be the position of a location, or we can say that position of a satellite there. To define the range, so we should know that a satellite and its clock, at what time, at what instant it transmits there. So, and that satellite clock and the earth clock is to be synchronized. So that's why in the navigation system, satellite carry atomic clock with an accuracy of 1 part in 10 to the power 11. Similarly, earth clock is designed using the crystal clock, and it is nothing but it's having accuracy of 1 part in 10 to the power 11 there. So that's why the clocks in the satellites on the earth and the satellites are synchronized there. If we consider the data transmission from the satellite, satellite transmitting a ranging signal that includes a time of a transmission and the position of a satellite in a space. And that data is called as a ephemeris data there. And the receiver measures its time with a crystal clock, and all the time delay measurements with the clock offset between the satellite and receiver have the error of a del t there. And that error del t in a clock offset introduce a range error in terms of what we can say, that is about a c into del t. Earlier we say that a range R1 from a given transmitter, so del t1 into c, but because of that error in a clock offset, so there will be error, range error, that will to be added, that is a c into del t there. So that's why we are having equation this one del t 1 c, and here we are having a tau c there, because a inaccuracy in a clock source, the receiver clock can have an offset of a tau in the time measurement with respect to the satellite clock. And there is a satellite, when a satellite transmit the data, so then satellite signal received by the receiver, it is having the propagation delay of the signal from the satellite. By taking the difference of the received and the transmission time, we can find out the range equation there. If there is accuracy of a receiver clock, then we can find out the range equations clearly. But inaccuracy in the clock source, then the receiver clock can have an offset. So that's why the range equations can be modified using the offset. And this offset in the clock resulted in the error that is measured in a form of a delay, and that a error is called as a tau c, range error. So we can calculate in the form of what we are having the error, okay, range error, and that error is nothing but what we can say, that is about the tau c here. So we can have range error that is nothing but this one tau c in a kilometer there. And we can have a delta t if supposed to be error in clock, so we can have that is about your clock offset there. So there is a delay we can have, okay, so we can calculate that here
a clock offset, we can have a error, range error there. So we can have a R1, we will calculate, and that error, if we consider only a 3 satellite, that error cannot be removed. So you can alternately remove that error using the 4 satellite. So with 4 time measurement, 4 unknowns we are having, t coordinates of x, y, z, and a receiver clock offset of error we are having. That is about it. Tau there. Okay, so we can have a offset. We can have a tau here. That is about your error offset here. Now we can calculate a ranging equations. If we consider that a 3 coordinate system, here we are having the receiver coordinates. We say that ux, uy, and uz, that is on the earth, and satellite coordinate system x, y, y, and z. Now here we have considered that a 4th satellite to define, or that is we can use to measure the distance there, and we can reduce that clock offset. So we can have a I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So we can calculate that range, pseudo range, that is PR1. Earlier we say that R1, R2, R3. Here we are saying PR1, PR2, PR3, PR4 here. That is the major distance to the satellite with a clock offset there. And the distance between the two points A and B in a rectangular coordinate system, we can calculate that. Here we are having the R square is equal to XA minus XB square plus Y minus YB square plus ZA minus ZB square. Similarly, we can calculate the ranging equations from the different satellite coordinate systems. If you consider that PR1 is for the first satellite, x1 minus ux, y1 minus uy, z1 minus uz, that is it from the first satellite to the receiver coordinate system, and this one is about your range, and here we are having that clock offset there. Similarly, we can calculate for the second satellite, third satellite, and the fourth satellite. We'll get the ranging equation, and with the help of that range of a fourth satellite, we can calculate a coordinate even though it employs a clock source with an offset. That is about your toe there. And this principle is used in a satellite navigation system, that is a global positioning system. Earlier saying, we have seen that there is a Navstar GPS is used, that is the first major satellite based navigation system that is deployed in 1978 by the US Department. Now then, there are a lot of navigation systems, that is GLONSS by Russia, then Galileo by Europe, Baidu by China, IRNSS by India, and QZSS by the Japan. So we'll see here a GPS system, and what are their advanced version that is used for the navigation system in the next lecture. Okay, thank you all.